Hi friends, this is a Star Laboratory production. Okay, today we are going to discuss about the Juran analysis chapter 6. So as we discussed earlier, in this Wedge-Juran analysis, we can further classify into two major categories, that is macroscopical analysis and the microscopical analysis. So if we take the macroscopical analysis, we can again subcategorize as physical and chemical analysis. So physical analysis we have already discussed in details. At the same time, in chemical analysis, again we are going to subcategorize into two groups, that is semi-quantitative and the qualitative. So in case of semi-quantitative, we can include the albumin and proteins and reducing substances. That also we have completed in the previous chapter. So if we take the qualitative analytes, we can include bilirubin or bile pigments, durobilinogen or bile pigment derivatives, then the ketone bodies, bile salts, and the Bence-Jones proteins. So today we are going to discuss about the ketone bodies and its identifications in the laboratory. So what is ketone bodies? How can they appear in the Juran sample and how can we diagnose in the laboratory? So let's see in details. So normal body does not contain any ketone bodies in Juran sample. So these ketone bodies associated with metabolic acidosis, it can be appear in starvation as well as in diabetic mellitus. So this starvation is a non-pathological condition and the diabetic mellitus is the pathological condition. So these ketone bodies are intermediately products of fat metabolism and they are present in the blood then in urine. So this presence of ketone bodies indicates that the metabolism is impaired or incomplete. So in the digestion process, these triglycerides can be converted into free fatty acids. At the presence of acetyl coenzyme A, these can be converted into ketone bodies. There are three types of ketone bodies. So first one, beta hydroxybutyric acid, then the second one, acetoacetic acid, then the third one is the acetone. So this beta hydroxybutyric acid is presented in large amount, that is 78%, but it is a non-volatile substance. But when we consider the acetoacetic acid, it can be presented nearly 20%, but it is volatile. At the same time, this acetone can be presented in very low amount, that is nearly 2%, that also a volatile substance. Then the determination of ketone bodies in the laboratories. So here we can use the reagent dipstick technique. So this reagent dipstick technique is very simple, rapid and convenient method. Then the second one is the Rothera's test. That is a simple test we can perform in the ordinary laboratory setups. Then the third one is the Gerhard test and the fourth one is the test for beta hydroxybutyric acid. So now let's discuss about the Rothera's test for the urine ketone bodies. So this Rothera's test can be used to detect urine ketone bodies. So this is also a very simple test we can perform in the ordinary laboratory setups. Now let's see what is the principle behind this Rothera's test. So this acetone and acetoacetic acid can be react with the sodium nitroprusside in the presence of alkaline medium. So as a result of this, we can observe the permanganate ring at the interface. Then now let's see what are the requirements needed for this Rothera's test. First, we need a positive negative control with test sample. Then we need pipettes of 10 ml, 5 ml and 0.5 ml. Three test tubes and labels. So one is for the positive control and the other one is for the negative control and one is for the test. Then we need ammonium sulfate solution, sodium nitroprusside solution. Then we need strong concentrated ammonia solution. Then now let's go for the method. So first of all, we should take three test tubes. So one is for the positive control, one is for the negative control, and the other one is for the test. Then we should do the proper labeling as shown in the figure. Then after that, we should mix the sample well along with the container. Then by using of this 10 ml of pipette, we should add 10 ml of urine sample into the related test tubes. That means positive to positive, negative to negative, and test to test. Then now we are going to add this saturated ammonium sulfate solution. So after mixing well, we should add 5 ml of saturated ammonium sulfate solution into the each related test tubes. Now I am adding 5 ml of saturated ammonium sulfate solution into the test. Then now let's add this 5 ml of saturated ammonium solution into the negative sample. Then finally, now let's add this 5 ml of saturated ammonium solution into the positive sample. After adding this saturated ammonia solution into the test tube, after that we should mix well, and then we should add this sodium nitroprusside solution. So now let's add this 0.5 ml of sodium nitroprusside solution. So normally in the laboratory, this sodium nitroprusside can be available in crystal states. After that, by mixing of distilled water, we should prepare the solution. So here I have already prepared the solution. So now let's add this 0.5 ml of sodium nitroprusside solution into the test. Then now let's add this 0.5 ml of sodium nitroprusside solution into the negative sample. So same like this, now let's add this 0.5 ml of sodium nitroprusside solution into the positive sample. After adding this, we should mix the sample well. Then finally, we are going to add this strong ammonia solution into the test tubes without disturbing. So in this Rodrás test, this final step is very very important. So without disturbing, we should overlay the strong ammonia solution. So firstly, let's overlay the strong ammonia solution into the positive control. So same like this, let's overlay the strong ammonia solution into the test and negative control sample. After overlaying the solution, we should wait for 5 minutes without disturbance. Then finally, the results interpretations. In case of positive sample, we can observe a permanganate purple color ring at the interface. That means, just below to the strong ammonia layer, we can observe this ring. In case of negative sample, there is no any color changes. Here the test sample also not having the color changes, so it is negative. That's all for today, friends. So thanks for watching. After watching this video, please give a like, leave your comments and share it. If you are not a subscriber, please subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell button. Thank you.